this talk is all about UAV. So UAV has, you know, many kinds of application. If you look at drone, right? Like drone is doing everything for Amazon. It's like, I mean, deliver one product from here to there. It can also be used for wireless communication. So here we'll talk about drone for wireless communication, right? If drone is used for wireless communication, how it is used? If you look at some playground, right? So soon people, you know, come there for like 3 hours, 4 hours. And you cannot use BTS for 3 hours there, right? In that way, you can have drone there. In the drone, we'll have BTS, okay? Suppose some disaster came somewhere, some area. So all the BTS is gone. So there they use a drone in the BTS itself, okay, for this particular kind of scenario for some time. So drone has lots of application. If you look at in the wireless communication, right? For example, playground, disaster management, there are so many applications. Recently there was Kumbh Mela. So Kumbh Mela, there will be an issue of frequency, right? Because there'll be so many people, you know, arrive at the same place. So then you can use actually drone for the Wi-Fi connection, and they have already used it, and drone for the wireless communication. So there are so many things you can use drone in this kind of scenario. Basically, what they have done is here, they have kept a balloon, like helium-based balloon, and then they keep a drone in that helium-based balloon. Okay, so like this, they use for wireless communication. So here there are issue of UAV here. Let us say this is the typical user, and there are 1, 2, 3, 4 drone is there, right? And there are 3 BTS which are on the ground, right? So there are two kind of service here. One is from the terrestrial BS, that is called drone. Sorry, that is a terrestrial BS, and other is called ABS, aerial BS and terrestrial BS. So this I'll call it TBS, and they are like drone is called basically aerial BS or ABS. If I serve a user from the aerial BS, so SNR will be very, very low. Reason being this, if all the drones will be using same frequency, let's just assume that. So signal will be coming from the nearest ABS. However, at the same time, interference will come from all other ABS. Okay. This is the way actually it will happen. So basically here, it is not, you know, good to use frequency, same frequency at each ABS because of low interference. I mean, low signal to interference ratio. Because here the interference will be at line of sight. If you look at only the terrestrial communication, right? The signal is coming from the terrestrial. Interference is also coming from the very far terrestrial. So here the interference will be blocked by many buildings. And hence SNR is not very, very low. But if you look at the ABS scenario, right, here between the BS and the typical UE, only link is line of sight. Also same thing for the interference, right? And hence if you look at here, SAR is going very, you know, down, all because of LOS kind of interference there. Now the question is, first of all, it's different from the terrestrial one, right? But because terrestrial, you will assume, if you look at the modeling part, right, you assume that all the BS are following hexagonal or the Poisson bound process. But here, this cannot be the case, because here the BTS is also in the air, right? So we cannot model with 2D. We have to model, you know, we have to use some like somewhat 3D model. But then problem with 3D that in 3D, they assume your BTS could be anywhere, right? So here BTS is, you know, on the terrace, on the, you know, terrestrial only. It is easy to model by 2D. If you use 3D, means the BTS could be anywhere. But in this case, BTS is either on the terrestrial ground, either on the ground or on the fixed plane, right? That is on the air. So we have to model something called something like this. It will be like 3D only, but there will be just 2 layers. Okay, so here you have user, and this ground you have all the terrestrial BS, BTS, and here you have like all the aerial BS, right? User will be somewhere here. And I'll assume that the aerial density of BS is higher than the terrestrial BS density. Okay. So this is what we'll be using. So basically here, there will be two kind of user. So here user can be get served by either terrestrial or by aerial, right? If it is getting served by terrestrial, we'll call it TUE, otherwise we'll call it AUE, right? So again here, depending upon the SNR, we'll see. So first we'll give chance to the terrestrial BS. Let me explain, you know, from here. Let us say we have like a frequency, F frequency. We'll divide the total F frequency into four parts, F0, F1, F2, and F3. The F0 will be given to all the terrestrial BS. So each of the terrestrial BS will be using frequency F0. Whereas we'll divide the frequency into three parts, that F1, F2, F3, and all the aerial BS will be using this F1, F2, F3 in a frequency reuse 3 manner. Okay, this is how we allocate the frequency. Because if you look at, the reason behind this is that if the signal is coming from, you know, aerial BS, right? So interference will have line of sight component, and hence we have to reuse the frequency at aerial side, not at the terrestrial side. Okay, so this is the idea. So basically we'll look at the user. If user is happy with the TBS, right, it's fine, we'll just getting served by TBS. If user is not happy, then we'll use aerial BS. Okay, so again the same thing. If you do that, so if you look at the coverage probability, so the coverage probability of proposed FFR for this aerial BS is this. Whereas if you don't use any FFR kind of scenario, the coverage is much lower than this, right? So there is a huge increment in coverage if you look at the FFR kind of scenario in the aerial BS, BTS, whatever you call it. This is what the coverage probability, you know, for the proposed FFR and the terrestrial network, right? So again here, proposed FFR coverage much better than the terrestrial network FR1. Okay, so average rate is this. This is the proposed FFR, right? Again, so average rate again of the proposed FFR is much higher than the aerial as well as terrestrial, kind of scenario, right? So this is what the comparing with FR1, right? It's much higher than the FR1. Okay, so yeah, this is all about aerial BS. So basically what I'm trying to say here, if you use aerial BTS for the wireless communication purpose, there should be some kind of frequency reuse in this. Otherwise, there will be huge interference issue in the case of drone, right?